Hi, I'm the children's librarian at the Scoville Memorial Library in Salisbury, Connecticut. Thank you so much for joining us on our story time here on CATV6. We're going to be reading a couple of different stories about cooking today, actually. I got hungry at the library and I thought, well, what can I read? So we're going to be reading some different stories that feature some different recipes. So as always, you're more than welcome to come into the library and check them out for yourself. If you want to read them at home, we have lots of others that have recipes actually included in the book. So before we get started with our book, we're going to do open shut them. So if you can join me with you opening up your hands and holding them up like this, we'll do it together. Open them, shut them, open them, shut them, give a little clap, clap, clap. Open them, shut them, open them, shut them, put them in your lap, lap, lap. Creep them, slowly creep them, right up to your chin, chin, chin. Open up your little mouth, but do not let them in. Okay, great job. Our first book today is called Cook a Doodle Doo. It's by Janet Stevens and Susan Stevens Crummell. And you might recognize a theme going through here. This is a bit of a takeoff on a book that you might be familiar with called The Little Red Hen. This is an adaptation. And it's called Cook a Doodle Doo. Peck, peck, peck. Always chicken feed, day after day, year after year. I'm sick of it, squawked Big Brown Rooster. Can we get something new to eat around here, please? Nobody's listening. What's a hungry rooster to do? There's no hope. Wait a minute. Rooster remembered a story his mama used to tell, a story handed down from chicken to chicken, the story of his famous great-grandmother, the Little Red Hen. Rooster rushed into the chicken coop. It has to be here, he said. He looked high and low, and there it was at last, hidden under a nest, her cookbook, The Joy of Cooking Alone by L.R. Hen. Rooster carefully turned the pages. So many recipes. I thought she just baked bread. Look at the strawberry shortcake. That's it. I'll make the most wonderful, magnificent strawberry shortcake in the whole wide world. No more chicken feed for me. Yes, sirree, just like Great Granny, I'll be a cook. Cook-a-doodle-doo, crowed Rooster as he pranced toward the big farmhouse. Cook-a-doodle-doo, said Dog. Have you lost your marbles, Rooster? Asked Cat. You never cooked anything before, said Goose. That doesn't matter, replied Rooster. Cooking is in my blood. It's a family tradition. Now, who will help me? What do you guys think? Who's going to help? Not I, said the dog. Not I, said the cat. Not I, said the goose. And away they went. Is it going to turn out just like the story in The Little Red Hen? Maybe. But Rooster pushed open the kitchen door. It looks like I'm on my own. Just like Great Granny. He sighed and put on his apron. We'll help you. Rooster turned, and there stood Turtle, Iguana, and Pot-bellied Pig. Do you know anything about cooking? Rooster asked.
I can read recipes, said Turtle.
I can get stuff, said Iguana.
And I can taste, said Pig. I'm an expert at tasting.
Then we're a team, declared Rooster. Let's get ready and start cooking.
Turtle read the cookbook. Heat oven to 450 degrees.
I can do that, said Iguana. Look, I'll turn the knob. 150, 250, 350, 450. Hey, cooking is easy.
Rooster put a big bowl on the table. What's our first ingredient? He asked.
The recipe says we need flour, said Turtle.
I
I can do that, said Iguana, and he dashed outside and he picked a petunia. How's this flower? Is that the kind of flower that Rooster is talking about? What do you guys think? No, you can't cook with that kind of flour. No, said Rooster, not that kind of flour. We need flour for cooking. You know the fluffy white stuff that's made from wheat?
Can I taste the flour?
Asked Pig. Not yet, Pig, said Turtle. The recipe says to sift it first.
What does sift mean? Asked Iguana.
Said Turtle. I think sift means to search through.
You mean like when I sift through the garbage looking for lunch?
Asked Pig. I can do that, said Iguana, and he dived into the flour, throwing it everywhere. Is that the kind of sifting that the recipe is talking about? What do you guys think? No, it's not. No, said Rooster, don't sift the flour like that. Put it through the sifter. Rooster turned the crank and sifted the flour into a big pile.
Can I taste the pile?
Asked Pig. Not yet, Pig, said Turtle. Now we measure the flour.
I can do that, said Iguana, and he grabbed a ruler. The flour is 4 inches tall.
Is that the kind of measuring that Rooster was talking about? No, it's not. You can't measure flour like that if you want your recipe to come out right.
No, said Rooster. We don't want to know how tall it is. We want to know how much there is. We measure the flour with this metal measuring cup. We need 2 cups,
said Turtle. So fill it twice. Rooster dumped 2 cups of flour into the bowl.
Can I taste it now?
Asked Pig. Not yet, Pig, said Turtle. Next, we add 2 tablespoons of sugar, 1 tablespoon of baking powder, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt.
I can do that, said Iguana.
He looked under the table. But where are the tablespoons? He looked in the teapot.
No teaspoons in here.
Are those the kind of tablespoons and teaspoons that Rooster was talking about? Is he going to find them under the table or in the side of the teapot? No, he's not. They're different kinds of spoons that are special spoons for measuring ingredients.
No, said Rooster, don't look in the teapot or under the table. These spoons are for measuring. Each holds a certain amount.
Rooster measured the sugar, baking powder, and salt and poured them into the big bowl and then sifted all of the dry ingredients together.
It looks awfully white in there, said Pig. I'd better taste it.
Not yet, Pig, said Turtle. Now we add butter. We need 1 stick.
I can do that,
cried Iguana. He raced outside and broke off a branch.
How's this stick?
Is that the kind of stick that Rooster's talking about? No, it's not. They don't need that kind of stick. They need a different kind of stick of butter.
No, said Rooster, not that kind of stick. A stick of butter.
Rooster unwrapped the butter and dropped it into the bowl.
That butter is just sitting there like a log, said Pig. Maybe I need to taste it.
Not yet, Pig, said Turtle. Next, we need to cut in the butter. I can do that, said Iguana.
Uh-oh, scissors don't cut butter very well. Can you really use scissors to cut butter? Well, maybe you could, but knives would work better.
No, said Rooster, don't cut the butter with scissors. Use 2 table knives like this.
Rooster cut in the butter until the mixture was crumbly.
It looks mighty dry in there, said Pig. Perhaps I should taste it.
Not yet, Pig, said Turtle. Now the recipe says to beat 1 egg. I can do that, cried Iguana. Oh, goodness, look what he has.
He has a baseball bat. Is that the way you should beat an egg? No, you're going to make a big mess if you beat an egg like that.
No, said Rooster, don't beat an egg with a baseball bat. We need an egg beater.
Rooster carefully broke the egg into a dish and beat it with the egg beater, and he poured it into the big bowl.
Oh, that looks tasty, said Pig. Please let me taste it.
Not yet, Pig, said Turtle. Now we add milk. We need 2/3 of a cup.
I can do that, said Iguana. Here, hold that glass measuring cup and I'll saw off a third. We'll use the other 2/3 to measure the milk.
Is that the way that they should measure 2/3 of milk?
No, that's not a good idea.
Wait, said Pig, why don't we fill the measuring cup to the top and I'll drink down a third.
No, said Rooster, the cup has marks on it. 1/3, 2/3, 1 cup. We'll fill it to the 2/3 mark.
Rooster poured the milk into the bowl.
It surely needs tasting now, said Pig.
Not yet, Pig, said Turtle. Now we mix the dough and put it into a greased baking pan.
Rooster stirred and spread as Turtle read, bake in the oven for 15 to 18 minutes.
I can do that, cried Iguana.
Iguana shoved the pan into the oven.
Let's see, 15 minutes equals 900 seconds. I'll count them. 1, 2, 3, 4.
No, said Rooster, and he set the timer so that Iguana would stop counting the seconds.
Pig burned his tongue on the oven door, trying to taste the shortcake.
Turtle studied the cookbook to see what they would do next.
Let's cut up the strawberries and whip the cream, said Turtle. And they cut and cut and whipped until, ding!
Rooster grabbed the oven mitt off Iguana's head and he took the shortcake carefully out of the oven.
Oh, it's beautiful and it smells so good, said Pig. I know I have to taste it now.
Not yet, Pig, said Turtle. We need to let it cool.
Soon the shortcake was ready to cut.
Rooster sliced it in half. They stacked one layer of cake, one layer of whipped cream, and one layer of strawberries. Then again, cake, cream, and berries.
It looked just like the picture of the strawberry shortcake in the cookbook.
This is the most wonderful, magnificent strawberry shortcake in the whole wide world, said Rooster. If Great Granny could see me now.
Let's take it to the table.
I can do that, cried Iguana.
He yanked at the plate. The shortcake tilted and slid, splat, right onto the floor.
Oh no, what a disaster. After all that work,
Pig was ready.
Now it's my turn to taste it.
In a split second, the strawberry shortcake was gone. Every last crumb had disappeared into the pot belly of the pig.
Our shortcake, Iguana cried. You ate it.
I thought it was my turn, replied Pig. I'm the taster, remember? And it tasted great.
But it was our masterpiece, moaned Turtle.
And a tasty one, too, said Pig. Now we can make something else.
Yeah, Iguana glared. How about a plump, juicy roast pig?
Pig gasped.
Roast pig? How about Iguana pot pie or turtle soup?
No, cried Rooster. Listen to me. We made this shortcake as a team, and teams work together.
But Pig ate it, whined Turtle.
Iguana dropped it,
pouted Pig.
Turtle should have caught it, grumbled Iguana.
It doesn't matter, said Rooster. The first shortcake was just for practice. It won't be as hard to make the second time.
Well, added Turtle, we don't have to worry about messing up the kitchen. It's already a mess.
So who will help me make it again? Asked Rooster.
Pig, Turtle, and Iguana looked at each other.
I will, said Pig.
I will, said Turtle.
I will, said Iguana.
Cook-a-doodle-doo, crowed Rooster. Let's get cooking again.
Together they made the second most wonderful, magnificent strawberry shortcake in the whole wide world. And it was a lot easier than the first time. Oh, and look, they're so nice. They're letting the cat and the dog and the goose have a helping of the shortcake, even though they didn't help make it. And one of the special things about this book is that it has a recipe in the back. So if you check it out from the library, you can make it at home. All right, well, that made me hungry. Well, we're going to continue with our food theme, and we're going to read a book called The Doorbell Rang by Pat Hutchins. And if you don't like shortcake, maybe you have a favorite cookie. This is about cookies, and I think they might even be chocolate chip cookies, which is some of my favorite kind of cookie. "I've made cookies for tea," said Ma. "Good," said Victoria and Sam. "We're starving." "Share them between yourselves," said Ma. "I made plenty." "That's 6 each," said Sam and Victoria. "They look as good as Grandma's," said Victoria. "They smell as good as Grandma's," said Sam. "No one makes cookies like Grandma," said Ma, as the doorbell rang. Who could it be at the door? Let's find out. Who's going to come in? Oh, it's friends from next door. It was Tom and Hannah. "Come in," said Ma. "You can share the cookies." Oh, now they're going to have to divide the cookies between 4 children instead of just 2. So let's find out how many each child is going to have. "That's 3 each," said Sam and Victoria. "They smell as good as your grandma's," said Tom. "And they look as good," said Hannah. "No one makes cookies like Grandma," said Ma, as the doorbell rang. Uh-oh. I think it's more people coming in. Maybe they're going to want to share the cookies. Sure enough, there are 2 more people. It was Peter and his little brother. "Come in," said Ma. "You can share the cookies." So now there are 6 children. Let's find out how many cookies they're each going to have. "That's 2 each," said Victoria and Sam. "They look as good as your grandma's," said Peter. "And smell is good." "Nobody makes cookies like Grandma," said Ma as the doorbell rang. Uh-oh. Who do you think it could be? It was Joy and Simon with 4 of their cousins. Look at all of the children they're going to have to share the cookies with now. "Come in," said Ma. "You can share the cookies." They're being so nice to share, aren't they? "That's 1 each," said Sam and Victoria. "They smell as good as your grandma's," said Joy. "And look as good," said Simon. "No one makes cookies like Grandma," said Ma, as the doorbell rang. Uh-oh. Should they open the door? As it is, they're only going to get, they have 1 cookie each. Let's find out. Are they going to open the door and be nice? It rang again. What are they going to do? "Oh, dear," said Ma, as the children stared at the cookies on their plates. "Maybe you better eat them before we open the door." "We'll wait," said Sam. Oh, good. He's going to be nice, and he's going to open the door, even if it means they might not get as many cookies. It was Grandma with an enormous tray of cookies. "How nice to have so many friends to share them with," said Grandma. "It's a good thing I made a lot." "And no one makes cookies like Grandma," said Ma, as the doorbell rang. All right, well, they were so nice to share their cookies. So we had strawberry shortcake, chocolate chip cookies, and the only thing we're missing now is cake. So our last story today is a book called Benny Bakes a Cake, and it's by Eve Rice. For Benny's birthday, Ralph gave Benny a big, wet kiss. What kind of animal is Benny? Let's see, I'm sorry, for what kind of animal is Ralph? Ralph is a dog, Benny is a little boy. Papa says, "Good morning, Benny. Happy birthday." And he goes to town with Jojo. I think Jojo must be his older sister. Mama gives him a hug. "Happy birthday, birthday boy. I'm going to make your cake. Will you help me bake it?" Have you guys ever made a cake before? Let's find out what they need to do to make a cake. So Benny helps to bake the cake. Benny sifts and Benny stirs. Oh, just like in our other story. And Benny makes sure Ralph is good. Then the cake goes in the oven. Finally, it's done. Mama sets it out to cool. Now we have to ice the cake. So Benny helps make the icing. Benny pours and Benny scrapes. And Benny watches Ralph while Mama spreads the icing on the cake and she writes, "Happy birthday, Benny," very big. There, all finished. Mama smiles and Benny smiles. Ralph licks his lips. Do you think that dog wants a taste of that cake? Looks pretty yummy, doesn't it? Mama says, "We still have time to take a walk." So Mama slips her apron off and Benny gets out his shoes. But where is Ralph? Uh-oh. What do you think Ralph is doing? There is Ralph. And there is Benny's cake. What happened to Benny's cake? Look, it fell off the table. Bad Ralph, bad dog, Mama scolds. But Benny doesn't say a thing. He just cries. Would you be crying too if your cake, birthday cake, fell off the table and got eaten by the dog? That would make me sad. The telephone goes ring, ring. "Hello, Papa," Mama says. An awful thing has happened. Ralph has eaten Benny's cake. Why, yes, of course. And then she says goodbye. "Don't cry. It will be all right. You'll see." Mama hugs Benny tight. And Ralph is very sorry, too. But Benny cries and will not stop. Suddenly, there's a knock at the door. Knock, knock. And Papa calls, "We're here, we're here. Someone open up." Benny stops, wipes his eyes, and opens up the door. Surprise! Oh, what did they get? They got a brand new cake as a surprise. Maybe they got it from a bakery. And then for Benny's birthday, everybody sings, "Happy birthday, dear Benny. Happy birthday to you." You know what I see? How many candles do you see on Benny's birthday cake? Let's count them. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 candles on Benny's birthday cake, so I think he's turning 4 years old. And it is a happy birthday too. All right, thank you so much for joining us for our story time here at CATV6. If there's a story that you'd like us to read, give us a call. You can give us a call at the library. It's 860-435-2838. You can also email me at esimmons@biblio.org. And you can go on our website if you'd like to find out more about those programs at the Scoville Memorial Library by visiting us at scovillelibrary.org. Thanks for watching. See you next time here on CATV6.